Before beginning this lesson, I'm going to quickly summarize all of the vertical alignment options available in Excel 2013. Let's begin by looking at row 1. This is an example of the general format. It's the default in Excel, and by default, text is aligned at the bottom of the cell. Now let's look at cell B2. I'll click cell B2 to make it the active cell, and then click the Home tab on the ribbon, and in the alignment group, I'll click the Top Align button. You can now see that the text is aligned with the top of the cell. Now let's look at the Middle Align option. I'll click in cell B3 and then click Home on the ribbon and in the alignment group, the Middle Align button. This time, the text appears in the center of the cell. Now let's look at cell B4. The text is already bottom aligned in cell B4 because that's the default, even though the cell actually has the general style applied to it. But I'm going to click in cell B4 and let's imagine that you've actually already applied a top vertical alignment and you want to restore the vertical alignment to the default bottom align setting. In this case, you can click the Bottom Align button, and when you do, the text is restored to the bottom of the cell. Now let's look at an advanced vertical alignment option, the Justify option. This isn't even shown on the ribbon because it's an advanced option, so I need to click in cell B5, then right-click and Format Cells from the shortcut menu to bring up the Format Cells dialog. Then I need to click the Alignment option, and notice that in the Text Alignment section, there's a Vertical Alignment drop-down. I'll click the drop-down button, and you can see the vertical alignments we've already set, top, center, and bottom. But there's two more, Justify and Distributed. I'll click Justify now, and then click the OK button. And you can see that Justify Vertical Alignment spreads the lines out so that the spaces between the lines are equal, but so that the text touches both the top and bottom border of the cell. The Distributed option is a little pointless because it produces exactly the same result as the Justify option. But for completeness, let's apply the Distributed Vertical Alignment option to cell B7. So I'll click in cell B7. Right-click and Format Cells. I'll set the vertical alignment to Distributed and click OK. And you can see that the result is identical to the Justify option that we set in cell B5. Well, now that you have an overview of what each of the vertical alignment options does, let's begin the lesson. For this lesson, you need to open the sample file Sales Week Ended 14th of March 2008, 5. And I'm going to begin by looking at the vertical alignment of cell A22. You can see that, at the moment, the text has the default vertical alignment of bottom, so it's floated to the bottom of the cell. But in this case, it would look better if the text floated to the top of the cell. So I'll select cell A22 and then click Home tab on the ribbon, and in the Alignment group, the Top Align button. I click Top Align, and that looks a lot better. Now I'm going to increase the height of row 4, using the skills you learned in Lesson 2.9. I click on the bottom of the row header for row 4, and then drag downwards to make the row a lot higher. You can now see why Bottom Align is the default in Excel. Bottom aligned text looks really good in column headers when you make the rows a lot taller. Focus now on invoice number in cell A4. I'd like to split the two words, invoice and number, so that they appear on different lines. Now you'll remember from lesson 4.6 that if you wrap text, then text will wrap onto multiple lines. So I'll click in cell A4 and then click Home tab on the ribbon and in the alignment group, Wrap Text. but you may be disappointed to see that nothing seems to have happened. And that's because column A is wide enough to accommodate the text invoice number without wrapping. Now I could make column A a little narrower, and if I did that, the text would be forced to wrap. But supposing I want to keep column A as wide as it is now, but I still want to wrap invoice number onto two separate lines. Well, to do that, I'd double-click in cell A4 and then click just to the left of the N of number. Next, I hold down the Alt key on the keyboard and press the Enter key. And then I'll press the Enter key once more just to finish off the edit. You can see that the numbers in column A have a right horizontal alignment. That's the default. So I'd really want to horizontally align the text in cell A4 to the right as well. So I'll click in cell A4, then Home tab on the ribbon, Alignment Group, and Align Right. I click Align Right, and everything looks a lot better. Let's now resize columns A to G so that each column is just wide enough for its contents. You discovered how to do this in one operation in Lesson 2.9. To do this, you need to click the Select All button at the top left of the worksheet, then hover the mouse over the intersection of any two columns and double-click, and every column in the worksheet is now the perfect size for its contents. Well, the worksheet's now beginning to look really professional. But in the rest of this session, you'll learn many more presentational skills, and the worksheet will look really fantastic by the end of Session 4. But for this lesson, all that remains is to save your work, and I'm going to save with the new name, Sales Weekended 14th of March 2008 6, and as usual, I'll save to the folder above, my Sample Files folder. I click the Save button, and you've now completed Lesson 4.7, Vertically Align the Contents of Cells.